Hey y'all, Kim Hazelton, the Funky OT here, and I am sharing some information with you this morning about handwriting over the summer. Now, if your kids are listening, they probably just went, oh no, we don't want to do any more handwriting over the summer. That's okay. We're not doing copy work. We're not doing handwriting. We're not even picking up a pencil or a piece of paper with this tip. Are you ready? See this wall behind me? Let me see if I can move out a little bit. It is a single fence panel. I'm going to be honest with you. I found this fence panel leaning up against the dumpster at my old office, and I grabbed it and we installed it in our backyard. It's just like a little focal point here, and it's been here, I'm trying to remember how old my daughter is. She's going to kill me if I can't remember her age. I think it's been here 5 years. 5 years. I'm not even going to say how old she is because that way I won't get it wrong. But it's been here 5 years, and we have decorated it with multiple things. So the first thing we decorated it for was my daughter's birthday, and we wrote happy birthday and, you know, drew like balloons and things like that on it. And we have since done, this is our second underwater scene that we're doing. We have done, I think she did an outer space scene one time. We did like a garden scene with flowers, and we did like angel wings, I don't know if you've seen where you can put like angel wings and have somebody stand in front of it and it looks like they've got the wings. And we wrote a little verse that said, you know, oh my darling, but what if you fly? And that was for her graduation. And we did photos out here with all of her and her friends. Anyway, this is my handwriting tip. If you can provide your children something vertical, and preferably something large to have lots of creativity and imagination to explore, that would be awesome. Outside is definitely a bonus, but if you don't have access to an outdoor space, put a piece of plywood or a big giant piece of chalkboard. Home Depot has a 4x8 piece of chalkboard in their lumber section that's like $10. And it's actually really good. It might even be better than real slate. And so we have that in my office. Anyway, we have had this for years. We use it for creativity and celebrations and working, you know, I'm not really working on skills with myself or my kids anymore. We're just having fun with it. But let me tell you what it's gonna work on. When your child is working on this, and look, we actually, I'm gonna see if you can see this. We've got a container of spray paint cans. So we are graffiti artists, apparently. And I actually have two more bags of spray paint in the patio because I want to add to this. This is my creation right now. This one's not my daughter's, and she hasn't even helped me with this one. But we use spray paint right now. So if you're using spray paint, if you're brave enough to do that with your kids, what are we working on here? We've got some finger isolation. We've got finger strengthening. We've got some grip because look, if I hold this spray paint can in my hand, look at my fingers. I've got thumb opposition, I'm holding it, a cylindrical grip, and if I'm pushing on the top, I'm isolating that index finger, excuse me, and I'm creating some strength opportunities, okay? If you don't wanna use spray paint, because it's a nightmare to get off, and it does get all over everything when you're doing it. So if you use it, make sure you don't like the clothes that, or you don't care about the clothes that they're wearing, or like put a smock on them, or you know, a garbage bag, like cut a hole in the bottom of it and put it over their head and put armholes in it. That's what we did at my daughter's birthday party. Everybody contributed to the picture, and we just put garbage bags over them. But if you don't want to use spray paint, you can use regular paint, paint brushes, sponge brushes, have them use leaves and sticks. And all of this is going to work on not just the hand. Now this is what most people think of when they think of handwriting, is we're going to fix the hand, but it's going to work on shoulder stability. Let's see if I can show you. If I'm working here, look at what my shoulder's doing. My shoulder is having to stabilize. My elbow and my wrist are having to stabilize. My wrist is an extension, so I'm facilitating that extension of the wrist, which is appropriate for an efficient pencil grip. My head and neck are being stabilized. My eyes are focusing directly in front of me. So we're going to start working on that visual motor and visual perceptual component of handwriting. And let's face it, we're outside. I mean, if you can get outside, it's just going to improve everything about your body and your mind. So get outside. If you can go barefoot, then you can start earthing, or grounding, depends on what you want to call it. If you're not familiar with what that is, look it up. We do it here all the time. I'm constantly barefoot so that I can, communicate. My body communicates with the earth, not in like a weird, funky way, but electronically. We have an electrical charge, and so does the earth. And so if we're not neutral and we come in contact with the earth, we actually can become a little more balanced electrically. That's it. It's nothing really funky. Even though I am funky, that's not too funky. So I hope that this has been helpful for you. In case you want to see, let me put that paint back. In case you want to see how we installed this. Oh, and look, I have my lemongrass here. I keep thinking I'm going to pull my lemongrass off and make lemongrass tea, but I just haven't done it. Haven't done it with my cranberry hibiscus either. But here's what we did. We put fence posts in behind in the ground. I want to say the fence posts are about maybe 2 or 3 feet into the ground. And then we just bolted it on. So you can see these bolts up here. Let's see if I can show you from the side. It literally is just like an old rotting fence panel here. And then if you look on the front, you can see the bolts. There's a little piece of moss. And we just paint over them. And then look, isn't he cute? So I think I'm gonna add some seaweed and maybe a starfish and a jellyfish. Maybe not a jellyfish, I'm not fans of them. I don't know, we'll see. But I'm gonna be creative and just enjoy the summer out here when I get the opportunity. All right, I hope that helps. You are gonna be able to work on your child's handwriting skills this summer without having to force them to pick up a pencil. They should find something like this way more fun. All right, have a blessed day, y'all. Love you.